India's most prestigious business quiz, Tata Crucible Corporate Quiz, is back for its 16th edition to challenge the best minds from India's finest companies.
146.
A platform that has put India's sharpest quizzing minds to the test.
In 1925, the Press Association of Great Britain decided to acquire a majority interest in them.
Writers.
150.
The Tata Crucible journey has grown every year, with extraordinary minds pushing themselves to the limit to rise above the rest.
It's an annual pilgrimage. I mean, 2006 I started, and every year since then I've participated.
It was absolutely nerve-wracking. One event which I always ardently waiting for the in the calendar is the Crucible.
In a 4.0 world where decisions are made on the go, the 16th edition of Tata Crucible Corporate Quiz featured over 1,500 participants who demonstrated their raw talent and their arsenal of knowledge on their way towards competing for the coveted top seat at the national finals. The quest to find India's quizzing champion ends here today. 25 cities, 8 finalists. The ultimate battle, where one team will be crowned as India's quizzing champion. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for the mind-bending final chapter, the national finals of Tata Crucible Corporate Quiz 2019.
Hello and a warm welcome to each and every one of you. You're with me, Pig Brain, here today on Times Now, witnessing the national finale of Tata Crucible for Corporates 2019. It simply does not get bigger than a battle like this. Outstanding corporates from across 25 cities of India have battled over the last couple of months, and you've been watching it as they make their place into their national final. With me here today are 8 outstanding teams, and I'm going to quickly introduce them to you. We've seen our 8 teams. It's time for us to play the national final of Tata Crucible for Corporates 2019. If we are ready, ladies and gentlemen, time for the national final. We begin with the first of those which we believe is innovation. On your screen, time for us to play on what we call ahead of the curve. Here it comes. Starting with the first one, may the best team become the national champion. On your screen, here we go. Here we are today at the Taj Mahal Palace. You could not have had a more innovative campaign run by the Taj Mahal Palace, where we stand today. Tata Consultancy Services taking the first shot. What's your strategy?
We'll go with the 150.
You're playing a 150. Go on.
Yeah, this is the former Jet Airways employees.
Oh, it's an ad campaign run by Taj Mahal Palace. It was India's perhaps first focused recruitment ad, which said the Taj Mahal Palace welcomes former Jet Airways employees to be part of its renowned heritage. 150. Question number 2, hands on the buzzer. Here we go. These were armored cars used by the British and American armies. They've gone for it. On my left is Kolkata on the buzzer. Strategy, stopping me, yes?
150.
150, go on.
These are called Tata Nuggets.
Minus 150. Continuing with my question, these were armored cars used by the British and American armies in World War I for hauling heavy artillery. This is actually an image of a New York City parade from 1918 featuring these specially made vehicles. Which company, known for creating vehicles that could hold heavy artillery, created these so-called tractors? Goa are taking a shot. 100 or 150, guys?
We'll go for 150.
150 is Savoy Fair. Go on.
And we'll say Caterpillar.
Caterpillar Corporation. Way back then was creating vehicles for armed forces and the world wars. Put your hands together. 150! Oh, beautifully played. As we go to the next one on screen, here we go. This is a company called Douglas Leigh. They were an American advertising innovation company. They became famous for making New York's Times Square the site for some of the world's best neon signs that was then called spectaculars. Douglas Leigh is often called the man who invented Times Square. In 1933, the first eye-catching billboard at Times Square said, it's taken a shot at it and stopped me. Go ahead, Kolkata. Capgemini, 100 or 150?
We're playing 100.
Playing at 100.
We'll say Heinz.
Minus 100. Minus 100, not waiting for me to finish. Oh. Pillai Steel Plant, not waiting for me to continue. 100 or 150?
We'll take a 150.
Taking a 150, go on.
Pepsodent.
We'll give you a minus 150. Well, team's really playing aggressive. The answer that I was looking for, 8 o'clock coffee from the history of Times Square. As we go to the next one, on your screens, here it comes. Why was this statue established in India? It marked the beginning of something in India. It was interpreted as, oh, TCS are taking a shot. 100 or 150?
You will go with 100.
Going with 100, not playing the full hog. Go on.
Our answer is the Lady of Progress at the Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, from where the first railways in India started.
Railway started from that location. Tata Consultancy Services, 100. Extremely well played for a 100. As we go to the next one. Hands on the buzzer. Here we go. This is the identity of an eponymous company founded by a pioneer who initially had a job with the Clyde Valley Electric Power Corporation. He tried to create diamonds by heating graphite. He also gave the world the glass razor among his inventions, which was rust resistant. However, you would associate this person to a far more commercial invention that all of us enjoy in our homes. This is the logo of his entity. Who's the person I'm talking about? Very great inventor. This is the logo of something that he created, which is all part of almost every home. Novartis are giving it a shot, 100 or a 150? Going with 100, go on.
We think that this is John Logie Baird's invention, the television.
Oh. The TV opened the eye of the world. And that was the line that he launched TV in the world. And this is John Logie Baird. 100. 100! As we go to the next one, on your screen, hands on the buzzer, here we go. Available in Abu Dhabi.
This is the Mysore Edition by Rolls Royce.
It's the what?
Mysore Edition by Tipu
Sultan. Mysore Edition?
Yeah, Tipu Sultan, Royal Emperor, so they have a Mysore Edition.
I said it's sold in Abu Dhabi.
Yeah, but they have this edition. Tiger is there. That is the Mysore edition.
Tipu Sultan is the Tiger of Mysore. Rolls Royce has something called the Mysore edition. Doesn't sell it in India, but sells it in the Middle East. 100. 100! Very early days, it's a national final and it's a 30-question final. A remarkable final unfolding with everyone putting in their best foot. But we need to take a very quick break. On the other side, all the action from the next frontier. Stay with us, back in just a moment. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You're watching a remarkable national final unfold here on Times Now as we move on to the second frontier. But before we do that, a quick look at where the teams stand on what we call Crucible Quotient. Here it comes. As we move on to the next frontier of our game here today, as we celebrate the second element in the four that we have chosen, leadership. But leadership by showing the way, not by telling people how to do it, but by leading by example. A tribute to some of those as we pick action on the second frontier to show the way. Here it comes. As we get started with the first one on your screens now. This diamond, Novartis have gone for it in a flash. What would you want to play, Novartis? 100 or 150?
We'll go by 100.
You will go with 100.
So this is, we think that this is a Jubilee diamond, which belonged to the Tatas in the 1920s. And they basically kept it on loan when they faced some trouble. And so the Jubilee Diamond basically saved the Tatas when they were in a pinch. And it was, I think, loaned by Dorab Tata in the 1924 or something.
For which company?
Tata Steel, I believe. But yeah.
That diamond on your screen, according to you, saved Tata Steel?
Yes.
100. 100! Here's the next one. On your screens, now. Nandini Krishnamurti. Novartis have gone for an early buzz. Strategy.
This is, we'll strategy. Go 100.
100 again. All right. They're just playing their hundreds.
It is
go on.
National Book Trust, NBT. The new logo of that.
National Book Trust. A creation of Nandini Krishnamurti and Snehal Rana. Put your hands together. Oh, well played. A new identity. As we go to the next one. On your screens, now. This is an animation and on my right, Bilai Steel Plant have gone for it. It's an animation series on your screen. 100 or 150, BSP?
150.
150.
The protagonist of the series is Karl Marx.
Put your hands together. And you played a 150 on that. So 150 to you as we go to the next one. On your screens, now. Why were these nibs purchased in the history of our country? These are specific nibs.
150.
250 odd of them were purchased.
150.
150, say Novartis.
Yeah, 150. Okay, so these nibs were specifically bought to write the Constitution of India. So these were ordered to write, because the Constitution of India is handwritten. And these nibs were the ones that were used to write the Constitution of India. So the answer is these were used to write the Constitution of India.
From the Jubilee Diamond to the Constitution of India, 150! Lot more to go as we go to the next one. On screen, here it comes. Buzzing and buzzing fast. Hashtag travel diaries.
150.
150 again, go on.
So, during the, JRD Tata's birthday is 29th of July, and this year to celebrate the birthday of JRD, between 22nd and 29th of July, the Tata Group basically started an Instagram account for Jay. It was called Tales of Jay. And this is a poem by a writer, I've forgotten his name, but he was basically the guy who used to write jazz poetry, the progenitor of jazz poetry, and this was supposedly J.R.D.'s favorite poem. So the answer is, this is an Instagram account by J.R.D. Started to basically celebrate his birthday between 22nd and 29th of July this year.
What happened after 29th?
Not sure.
J.R.D. being J.R.D. left Instagram. Put your hands together. Novartis 150. They're really, really beginning to press the accelerator as we go to the next one on your screens now. 100 or 150? Bilai Steel Plant are taking a shot at it.
150.
150, they say. Go on.
I think this is a book by Shakuntala Devi, a mathematician.
The world of homosexuals. What is this? A mathematical total of...
one and zeros.
Shakuntala Devi. And you chose to play 150.
Yes.
Extraordinary answer. 150. Deserves the better applauses. Bilai Steel Plant. As we go to the next one. On your screens now. Windows on the world. Buzzing quickly is Tata Consultancy Services. 100 or 150?
We'll take 150. This is the restaurant on top of the WTC, the World Trade Center. It's unfortunately no more. This was the restaurant on top of it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it went by a simple line and it said, "Welcome to the restaurant a quarter mile high in the sky on the World Trade Center." Put your hands together. TCS. A 150. All of these scores are going to be extremely crucial as we move on to the next one. On your screens, careful. Here we go. Primary targets of B-29 from China bases. Novartis at it again.
150.
Monarch Airways, 150. They're really playing aggressive now.
So this
I think the confidence is beginning to grow. Yes.
The connect is Operation Matterhorn, right? Which was basically started to get back the travelers who were using Thomas Cook when it collapsed. Operation Matterhorn is also the name of the operation which the Britishers, rather the US used to bombard the Japanese air bases from India. Monarch UK was the largest civilian airtime getting back of civilians till Operation Matterhorn came in, which became the largest. So the connection being Operation Matterhorn, which is the
to evacuate
the people who were using
Thomas Cook
when it collapsed.
Sensational stuff. Oh, this is sensational stuff. Another 150 to Novartis on that. Here's the next one on your screens now. These are...
We'll go for a 150.
Savoy Fair. Going for a?
We'll go for a 150.
You're playing aggressive without me even speaking a word. Goa.
This is a kind of a fortification device which is for protection called a hoarding. And so that's where we get the term called hoarding, which is used in advertising, like a large billboard is called a hoarding.
Okay. 150. 150! Nothing gets past intellectual India, if I should put it that way. Superb quizzing. The final one in this frontier on your screen leads you to a profession. Here we go. Tata Consultancy Services. Identify a profession.
150.
150 after a discussion. TCS need those 150s.
First one is Ferrari.
The first one is Ferrari.
Then Ferrero Rocher. So it's all...
Ferrero Rocher.
So it's all got to do with iron or rock or whatever it is. So that's basically the word which, or the profession which connects them. Fabre Louvre was also...
All the names are derived from the words for iron or blacksmithing. Oh.
So Ferrari is Ferris. Ferrero Rocher is Ferris. Favor in another language is Ferris. So all of that leads you to iron, so it leads you to blacksmiths. 150. 150. Remarkably played. All of these would work up to ferrum technically, and favor in French is iron. So all of them would lead you to a ferris or an ironsmith or a blacksmith answer. Beautifully worked out and craftily played a 150 at that. We'll see what that's done to the crucible quotient as an impact. We'll take a look on the screen.
This Tanishq model for the male line of jewelry, branded Avir, began his career selling locks.
Bhaskar Bhatt.
Give them a big, big hand.